Determine the truth value of P or Q and not R if A, P is true, Q is false, and R is true. Well, the first thing we'll do is just substitute the truth values into the given statement. We'll substitute true for P, false for Q, and true for R. That gives us true or false and not true. Well, let's start inside the parentheses and specifically with the negation. We have not true. Well, if something's not true, then it must be false. So now we have true or false and false. Well, inside of the parentheses, we've got a conjunction. And the only way that a conjunction can be true is if both parts are true. In this case, both parts are false, so the conjunction must be false. Now our statement is true or false. We have a disjunction. The only way that a disjunction can be false is if both parts are false. In our case, we have the first part is true and the second part is false, so the whole statement must be true. So our conclusion is that the given statement is true if P is true, Q is false, and R is true. Well, let's take a look at part B. What is the truth value of the statement if P is false, Q is true, and R is true? This time we substitute false for P, true for Q, and true for R. Just like before, we start inside the parentheses with our negation. Not true is false. The next thing we have inside of parentheses is conjunction. We have true and false. So looking up true and false in our table, true and false is false. The only way that a conjunction can be true is if both parts are true. Finally, we have the disjunction false or false. So looking that up in our disjunction table, we see that false or false is false. In fact, the only way that a disjunction can be false is if both parts are false. So we end up with a false statement overall. Our conclusion is that the given statement is false if P is false, Q is true, and R is true.